Okay, so in today's class, so we are going to discuss regarding the coating of tablet or the tablet coating. So in coming to the tablet coating, so we are going to coat the tablet for various purposes. So like either to improve its appearance or to mask its odor or its bitter taste, or to protect from the environment like oxidation and all, or from the chemical protection, or either to protect the drug in the stomach, or to prevent the irritation and all, either to so give your tablet a good appearance and a good look. Okay, so in coming to the tablet coating, so like it is the oldest pharmaceutical process. So either it involves the application of the sugar or the polymeric coat on the tablet. The advantage of this coating, so either you are going to mask the taste or you are going to mask the odor. So like if it is having bitter taste, so like the small children's, like they can't consume it due to the bitter taste. Okay, so just you are going to give a sugar coating so that it will be sweeter in taste, and the small children's, they are going to easily accept it. And you are going to give the various colors. So like you have seen the Cadbury gems and all, so like that they are going to coat, they are going to apply a sugar coat over it, and they are going to give gloss, or they are going to make it shinier so that it can be easily accepted or liked by the children's. Okay, so apart from that, you are going to prevent the drug from the chemical or the physical degradation, so like the oxidation or few drugs, so they are prone to chipping. So in the packet only, they are going to release the chips or the fragments. To protect that, you are going to use the coating, or to protect the drug in stomach. So like if few drugs, so they are undergo degradation in the stomach. To prevent that, you are going to go for the coating, or to control the release of drug. So you want the drug to be act for prolonged period of time, or you want the sustained release of the drug, or delayed release of the drug, or so like that, you can modify the release by using the tablet coating. So in coming to the like its properties or its advantages, so it is going to protect the drug from degradation in the stomach. So like we are going to go with an enteric coating. So like this enteric coating, so means the drug is not going to release in the stomach, so it is going to release in the intestine. So here you are going to use the polymer, so that are going to degrade in the intestinal pH or the alkaline pH, that is like more than 8 or 10. So that is going to be degraded in the intestine. They are going to resist the stomach or the stomach pH, so your drugs can't be released in the stomach. So either to prevent the drug induced irritation, so in the GIT, so like few tablets like the aspirin and all, if you are going to take, so that is going to cause irritation or burning sensation in your stomach. To protect that, we can coat the tablets, so it is going to cause less irritation or less burning sensation in your stomach. So like so either to provide the controlled release of the drug, so if you want to attain the, or if you want to modify the release pattern of the drug, you are going to go with the coating. Or like if you want the delayed release, if you want the control release, so you can go with the coating. So if you are going to go with the control release, so then it is going to cause less side effects, like in the stomach. So like your aspirin and all, that is going to cause burning sensation, or that is going to cause the irritation or ulceration. So if you are going to modify the release, so then the chances of the ulceration or the burning will be less. Or to target the drug release into specific site, so like the enteric coated tablets, so that are used to release in the intestine, so that is you are going to target for the intestine, so that the drug is not going to release in the stomach, and directly that is going to release in the colon, or that is in the small intestine. Or to mask the taste of the drug, or to improve its appearance, so like you are going to provide a shining gloss to the tablet, so that everyone is going to like that. So okay, so in coming to the techniques of the coating, so generally there are three methods. that is the traditional or older method. So one is the sugar coating, so one is the film coating, and one is the enteric coating. Okay, so in coming to the sugar coating, so in this method, so we are going to so make a deposition of a thick layer of aqueous sugar or the thick layer of sugar solution on the top of the tablet. So again, either to improve its appearance or its glow, to give it a shine, or to give it different colors, or to mask the odor, or to mask the taste, or to increase the thickness of the tablet, or to protect the tablet from the environmental condition. So for sugar coating, so like you see in the best example, that is the your Cadbury gems. So like that is the sugar coated that thing only tablet like that. So here, so it is generally made for the small children's. So those who are going to refuse the bitter tablets, so for them they are going to coat the tablet with a sucrose solution or the sugar solution. So same as that of your Cadbury gems. So you are going to, you can apply the various colors. You are going to give a gloss or shiny. Okay, so you can give a nice appearance to that tablet. So it can be easily accepted by the children's. Or apart from that, you can so mask the, or you can remove the odor, you can remove the bitter taste. Okay, so you can protect the drug from the environmental condition and all. So in coming to the steps, so that is going to involve in the sugar coating. So it generally like involve 5 steps. So one is the sealing or waterproofing. So in this method, you are going to apply a waterproof, that is the polymer. So that is going to provide a moisture barrier. So means next you are going to apply the aqueous sugar layer, so that contain water. So if it contain moisture, so then your tablet, it can be easily going to absorb the moisture, and it can be easily undergo degradation, or it is going to break down there only. So to prevent that, the first you are going to do a waterproofing, or you are going to apply a waterproofing layer over the tablet surface. So this is going to provide a moisture barrier, and it is going to make your tablet hard or surface hard, so that it is not going to release any of the flakes, or it is not going to break down. So second step, that is the sub coating. So here you are going to provide a sugar coating layer, so that it is going to build up, or it is going to increase the size of the tablet, and as well as it is going to round off the tablet edges. So like it is going to make the edges round. So yes, in case you have seen in case of the Cadbury gems, the edges, so like they are like somewhat rounded, so that is going to attain in the sub coating process. So next is the grossing or the smoothing. So here so after the sub coating, so you are going to go with the smoothing. So again, you are going to apply a sugar coating layer, so to increase the size of the tablet, or to increase the smoothing of the tablet, or to increase the thickness of the tablet for a certain dimension or the desired size which you want. So next is the coloring. So here you are going to give the various colors, and you are going to give the finished size for the tablet. And the last step is the polishing. So here you are going to apply the polish for the tablet to increase the gloss. Okay, so next coming to the sealing or waterproofing. So as already discussed, so before applying the sugar or the water syrup, the tablet cores or the edges, it should be sealed, and it should be thoroughly dried, and it should be free from the solvents. That is, it should be moisture free. If it contains moisture, so it undergo degradation or hydrolysis, or it is going to break down into pieces. To prevent that, so before applying the sugar coat, you are going to make the tablet waterproof. So you are going to provide a seal, so that should be is going to prevent the tablet from the moisture. Okay, so here you are going to apply the seal. Okay, that is going to provide a moisture barrier, and it is going to make the tablet harder on the surface, and in order to minimize attirational effect. So as already discussed, attirational effect means, that is the chipping. So in that, during the tablet polishing, so the tablet are being rotated in the pan. Okay, so like here you can see this rotating pan. So in this, your tablets are going to rotate. So during that, it is going to touch to one another, or the friction or the iteration is going to achieve. So that is going to cause the chipping or breaking of the tablet. Okay, so to prevent that, you are going to apply the waterproofing or the sealing to the tablet. So it is going to make your tablet moisture resistant, and it is going to make your tablet harder, that it should be resist the iterational effect. Okay, so when coming to the sealants or the sealing agents, so they are generally water insoluble polymers, or they are the film forming polymers, so which is formed by dissolving in the organic solvent. So we are not going to use the water, so we are going to use the organic reduce the solvent. Okay, and you are going to dissolve these polymers because they are water insoluble, and you are going to apply over a coat on the tablet to make it seal. Okay, the commonly used material for the film forming, so they are the shellac, zinc, cellulose acetate phthalate, that is the CAP, polyvinyl acetate phthalate, that is the PAP. Okay, so HPC, that is the hydroxypropyl cellulose, HPMC, that is the hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose. So like these are the agents which are going to apply on the tablet to make it seal. Okay, so next is the subcoating. Okay, so like in the subcoating, you are going to start the sugar coating process, or it is the initial step of the sugar coating. So it is going to provide the rapid buildup of the necessary round of the tablet. So you are going to apply the sugar coat, that is going to make your tablet like round, and the edges are going to become smooth, and it is going to act as a foundation for the smoothing and for the color coating. So like you are going to apply a sugar coat, so that is going to make your tablet round, and that is going to increase the thickness of the tablet. So you are going to do so because it is going to provide the base or foundation for the next steps, that is for the smoothing and for the color application or for the color coat. So here it is, you are going to apply the sub coating by using two methods. So first, you are going to apply the gum based solution followed by with the dusting powder, then drying this routinely, and you are going to repeat the this step again and again till the desired shape is going to achieve. Okay, so here you are going to take the sugar, and you are going to use any of the binding agent, so that is like the acacia and all. So after, you are going to apply a coat of the sugar or the tablet, then you are going to use the dry, that is the dust, that is the powder. So why you are going to use the powder? So means it is going to reduce the friction between two tablets. So you are going to apply the gummy or sticky layer, that is the sugar layer, so to prevent the tablet from sticking to one another. So you are going to spray the dusting powder, so after applying coat, then again you are going to apply the sugar coat, then again you are going to apply the dry powder, so that is going to prevent the tablets from being attracted or attached to one another. Okay, so this step you are going to repeat until the desired shape you are going to achieve. Okay, so next, the second method, so the application of a suspension of dry powder in gum. Okay, so here you are going to apply or add the powder directly into the sucrose solution. Okay, so then you are going to dry. In the first, you are going to take the sugar solution, then you are going to spray the dusting powder. In this, you already have applied the dusting powder, that is the powder in the sugar solution only, that it is going to prevent the sticking of the tablet to one another, and you are going to dry. So this sub coating, so it is a sandwich of alternative layers of gum and powder. So it contains the various layers of the gum and the powder, so it is necessary to remove the bulk of water after each application of coating. So like after applying each coat, you need to remove the water or you need to remove the moisture. So you are going to dry it, and again you are going to apply the sugar coat, again you are going to spray with the powder, and again you are going to dry, again you are going to apply the sugar coat. So like till the desired thickness is achieved, so you are going to repeat this process. So next is the grossing or smoothing. So when coming to the grossing or smoothing, so in this process it is used for smoothing and filling the irregularity on the surface. Okay, so it is generated during the subcoating. Okay, so during subcoating, so few of the tablets, so they may stick to one another and there will be uneven distribution of the that is the sugar coat on the tablets. So to coat that irregularly coated tablet, you are going to go with the smoothing process. So it is going to fill the irregularly coating, it is going to make the coating again, so it is going to increase the tablet size to a predominant or predetermined dimension. Okay, so the tablet which have irregularly coated or which have not so all have been coated, so that has been coated in this step. So again you are going to apply a sugar solution layer to the tablet, so to attain the desired dimension. Okay, so like it is simply it is done by using the syrup or solution or the sucrose solution which contain 60 to 70% of sugar which is dissolved in water, or like 70 gram in 100 ml of water. So it contains 60 to 70% of sugar which is dissolved in water, so you are going to apply. And the last next step is the color coating. Okay, so in this you are going to apply the multiple application of the sugar solution, so containing the coloring matter. So you are going to add the color into the sugar solution and you are going to apply for a several time, so till you are going to coat the desired color. So you are going to use the water soluble dyes and the colors which have been used by approved by the that is the FDC and FDA. Okay, so few of the colors, so they are going to migrate during the drying. So again you are going to dry and again you are going to coat till it is going to coat entirely the tablet. And the last step is the polishing. Okay, so here you are going to give the gloss or you are going to give the shining to the tablet, or so you are going to give the final elegance to the tablet. So in this you are going to use the various waxes like the beeswax, chronoba wax, candela wax or the hard paraffin wax, and you are going to use the polishing pan. So like this is the coating pan, so similar to this the polishing pan will come. So here you can steal the steel drum, instead of that it contains the clothed drum. Okay, so it contains the drum which is having the cloth, and so you are going to add the wax and you are going to rotate the that drum by putting the tablet in it. So it is going to provide the shiner or it is going to provide the gloss to that tablet. Okay, so this is all regarding the that is the sugar coating process.